Welcome to your own channel of Right Funda. Here is a very interesting question from kinematics. Let's read the question first. A rocket moves horizontally with a constant velocity V at a height h. A guided missile is fired vertically with same speed V when the rocket passes above it. Assuming that the missile always aims at the rocket with a constant speed V, find the final separation between both, that is rocket and missile. So what the question is saying, if you see, this is rocket is here and this rocket is going with a constant velocity, like this, the horizontal is going, it is going the horizontally with a constant velocity, this is my rocket. And it was going from like this, and when it was just here above the missile, it fired a missile starts going towards the rocket. But as the rocket, it's a guided missile is there. As the guided missile is there, it will be always approaching the rocket. Always approaching the rocket. So after some time, the missile will be, rocket will be here. So it will not go like this. It will be turning toward like this. So it will be moving like this at that time. It will be aiming toward this. After that, it moves from here to here. So it will also turn the directions. It will go like this. It will turn It will go like this. They might collide, may not collide. So as it is going like this, sometime rocket is reaching here and missile is reaching here. Once they are reaching, in this question, this is given that both are same. V and V are same. Once they reach like this, after they will be approaching. But as the velocity are same, they will never be meeting each other. Their velocity are same given. So it is asking that what is this distance? What is the separation, final separation between the missile and the rocket? So rocket moves like this, horizontal velocity like this. And missile goes like this. Okay. After that, because the velocity are same here, they'll be going. So we have to calculate this distance. What is given? This height is given as h. H height is given. And both the velocity v and v are given to us. So this rocket is with a constant velocity and missile going with a constant speed. But its direction is changing. So now you have understood the question. Now if you wish, you can pause the video. Try solving the problem. After a few minutes, once you finish the solving the problem, then you can again resume the video and you can see the solution. So let's discuss the solution. So as we discuss what is happening, suppose I gave this some name to this. This is my height there. This I say, suppose this is my x-axis. And this I take the y-axis. X I have taken the horizontal, y I have taken the vertical. And initially the missile was here. And the rocket was here initially and it moves with the V velocity, but it always aimed toward this. So it may be like this, anything, the variable velocity. It's a variable velocity, but speed is constant in this particular problem given. So at any point of time, suppose at any point of time, at time t, the rocket, the missile is here. If missile is given, this is the path of the missile given, the pink line. Okay? If the missile is here, where should be the rocket? Because missile is always aiming toward the rocket. So if I make a tangent, if I draw a tangent here, then where will be meeting? At that time, definitely the rocket must be there. Because the velocity of the missile must be at that instant toward the rocket. Because a guided missile is aiming toward the rocket. So this is missile, this is rocket, and it goes like this. And finally, suppose it is reached here sometime. And at that time, this will be here. So this is missile has reached this point, M dash point and R dash point. And this distance is, suppose the final separation, I given the name D. So initial distance separation H and the final distance separation D. But H in the J cap direction, D in the I cap direction. So how to solve this type of problem? How to solve this type of problem? And this is not a constant velocity. This is with a constant velocity, but this is with a variable velocity this moving. So definitely something is coming to our mind that due to variable velocity, variable acceleration, usually we solve by the integration method. But let's see how it can solve. So if you see the ground reference, ma'am, it is little bit, it is going like this, how they'll be meeting, where they'll be reaching, it's little bit complicated. But if I see in the one body's reference frame, missile's reference frame or rocket reference frame, then we'll see what we can do. So if I see in the missile reference frame, missile will be rest and rocket will be moving something like this and it will be coming to this. If I see the rocket reference frame, missile, this rocket is at rest and missile will be moving like this and something because they move with a variable velocity, not constant velocity. So let's calculate this one, velocity, the rocket or something will be calculated. So let's, we see, At any time t, it is there like this. So along this, there are two axes we will take. The first will discuss the along the line joining the missile and the rocket. So I extend this one. So this is my an axis I have taken. Suppose n cap direction, the unit vector n cap I have taken. This is the along the line joining missile and rocket at any instant of time. At any this is a variable direction. This axis will not be. Suppose sometime missile is here, rocket is this is the direction. Some missile is here, rocket is this the direction. So this is a variable direction, but at a particular instant, I take an axis like this along the line joining missile and the rocket. If I say along the line joining missile and rocket, then what will happen? So we'll resolve every vector along this thing, along the line joining the missile and rocket. So at this point, I'd say everything has to be resolved along this direction. So right now, the velocity of the missile is in this direction, that is V. But this is V in my thesis. So in this direction, what is the component will be there? The component of this V along this direction is equal to V and the angle of this one. Suppose, assume that this angle is equal to theta. At that time, missile is making a theta. Missile initially is going like this, it turned like this and going like this. Right now, let's take this angle theta. If this is angle theta, then this is also angle theta. And this is theta. This velocity's component along this direction will be equal to V cos theta. So missiles, the rocket's velocity along this line joining the rocket and the missile is V cos theta. And velocity of the rocket, missile along this direction equal to V. And velocity of the rocket is V cos theta. And velocity of the missile is equal to V. So what is the relative velocity? What is going to calculate the relative velocity between this? And we are doing along the line joining the missile and the rocket. Along this line we are doing. So if you want to show, so that the velocity of the rocket, we have to calculate in the missile reference frame. Velocity of rocket is through missile is equal to velocity of rocket minus velocity of missile. And this is along along the direction of missile rocket direction. This is a particular direction. And this is a variable direction we know. And along this direction, missile to rocket is along this direction we are writing. So the components are there. We are not writing vector. They are the component along this direction, only positive negative to consider, because only a particular direction we are writing, not the net velocity. So I can write the in place of this, what I can write? Velocity of rocket is equal to V cos theta. Velocity of rocket is V cos theta, and velocity of missile at that time is equal to V along this line, V cos theta, in case of velocity of rocket along this direction equal to V cos theta. And this is equal to, I can the rate of change of position vector rocket is through missile along that direction, along missile and direction is the position vector of this. The rate of change of position vector is equal to velocity. So velocity of rocket is the missile along that direction. You rate of change of position vector of the rocket is the missile along that direction. So if I take the dt to that side, then I can write it d r, the position vector of the rocket is the missile along that direction, v cos theta dt minus v dt. Now I can integrate both the sides. I can integrate both the time. And suppose I take this time here to here, it take time to t time. For this to reach the horizontal level of the rocket, we take t time, capital T time. So I'll be integrating this. If I integrate this one, then what I can do is equal to this. And try to understand the limit. So if both the side I integrate it, and V is a constant quantity, that's why I've taken outside. And I can integrate this, I can integrate this, I can integrate this. Take care. So at what the limit will be there? At t is equal to 0, the distance separation between them along the line joining. What is the along the line joining? Initially, the line joining, initial line joining was like this. Initially, the line joining was like this. So distance separation between them in the initial instant, the distance separation between them was h. And after t time, they will be reaching at that point when the distance separation, final distance from the t time, it happened. And after that, remain constant. So let distance separation be d. So try to understand the limit at t is equal to 0. This left hand side limit at t to 0 to t, and it's equal to h, initial distance separation along the line journey, because initially along the line journey like this. So along that direction distance was h was there, and final distance separation along this line. Initially, this is the line, that same distance, the variable direction, finally the direction become like this, is equal to t. So we need to integrate from this to this, and v is a constant quantity given, speed is constant quantity. So speed I can take outside. And I can write like this. So this is my h2t. So we integrate left hand side, then this is equal to dr, rm, integration dr equal to r will be there, and I put the limit then I can got left hand side is equal to d minus h, and the left hand side second term is equal to v dt integration t vt. But this term we don't know. These are terms we don't know. What is the value of these terms? We don't know. So to carry out this intimation, I should know theta as a function of time, or time as a function of theta, or sine cos theta as a function of time to be written. But I don't know how it is moving the theta. There's a tedious affairs. So let it be write like this. Let it be like this. And let's, in this type of problem, if you cannot integrate something, you cannot integrate, we have to eliminate this one. So we'll write another equation so that we can eliminate this one. Okay? So we got an equation till now. We got an equation right now. We'll put in a box right now. So this is the equation side of time. Okay, d minus h is equal to this. Let call this an equation number 1. Okay, now what you will see, now I'll jump the same thing we'll observe, same phenomenon we'll observe, but let's observe this in horizontal direction. First we did in the, along the line joining the rocket and missile, let's do in the horizontal, along the horizontal direction. So we have to resolve everything in the horizontal direction. So it is already in the horizontal direction, the v velocity, but it is going the v velocity in this direction. So for this angle, we have taken this angle theta, same thing. So now this component become v cos theta, and other component become v sin theta. I have not written. This is v sin theta. But I am interested about the horizontal direction. So in horizontal, v velocity, v cos theta. Let's write the relative velocity along the horizontal direction. If you write the velocity in the horizontal direction, let's see what is happening. Velocity in the horizontal direction, right? Then again, velocity of rocket with missile equal velocity of rocket with respect to missile along the x direction. So horizontal direction. So what is x, 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 etc. So they are not vector; they are the components, and the along the x direction. So I can write drm by dt in the x direction is equal to what is the velocity? Velocity of rocket is x v, and velocity of missile in the x direction will be v cos theta. I'll take the dt to that side. Then I got this one equations. Okay, again I will be integrating both the sides. If I integrate both the sides, this to be integrated. And I know v is constant, v can be taken outside of the integrations. We have discussed v the speed of the particles, rocket and missiles. So I take the v out of the integration, I got like this. Now I will be putting the limit again. At t is equal to 0, what is this? Distance separation between them in horizontal direction. This is horizontal direction. So in the horizontal direction, where is there? Missile was here. So the rocket was here. Missile was there. What is the distance of them in the horizontal direction? No distance of them because its x coordinate also 0 and its x coordinate also 0. Of course, there is 0 comma 0 is there. This is 0 comma h is there. So x direction, there was no distance separation between them there. So I'll write distance separation between them in the x directions. Relative positions ka x coordinate ka difference equal to 0. And at time t, that the final separation happened, the distance separation between the horizontal direction become how much? D. So we'll put this d value here. So once we put the d values and then we can integrate, left hand side integration again will be equal to d x rm equal to x rm will be there. So put the letter d minus 0, left hand side integration d minus 0, d, and first level of v dt integration t and v cos theta dt integration. We don't know, of course, we don't know. This value we don't know. But from this, what we advantage happened that we got the value of the v dt integration, v cos theta dt integration, v cos theta integral to v t minus d that we obtained from the while writing the equation from the horizontal directions. So let's call this equation number 2. So from the equation number 1 and 2, we can eliminate this quantity. So let's take this value and substitute in the first equation. Let's see what is the first equation was there. The v into cos theta dt integration we obtained v t minus d. And what is the first equation? D minus s. And in this place, we'll be putting vt minus d that you can put here. So this quantity, whatever you obtained, v dt integration, we could substitute because taking from two equations, second number question of equation, the integrand values in the first equation, d minus h, that I can write here as the d minus h is equal to, in place of the first terms that we have written, this quantity I have written, vt minus d I have written, minus vt. So that quantity was, I was not able to integrate because I don't know the functional dependence of theta with t, that had been eliminated. So my purpose is solved. Now I see this vt, they will be cancelled out. Once vt cancel out the d, I will take to that side, then they become d plus d is equal to h. I have to go to this side. So I got a 2d is equal to h, or d is equal to h by 2 that I obtain. What is d? D the final separation between them. What is h? H is the initial distance separation between them in the y directions. When they do h height, it was there. So in this problem, we found out that velocity of the part, velocity, if they are moving the same velocity, and they will be never be meeting each other, and final separation will be if it is fired when it is at the exactly opposite point, and it always follows this with a constant velocity, and their velocities are speeds are same, and moves with a constant speed and follows it, always aiming toward this, then the final distance separation will be h by 2. So let's summarize what we did again. Once again, I say, we have seen this is always following this one, is a guided missile over there. So at any time t, this particle, this positions I have taken, let this angle be theta, we don't know the theta value, but at the aiming, rocket must be here. So first case, we have taken the along this line, we wrote the equation along this line, find the relative velocity along this line, and correspondingly we integrated from 0 to t, and their values along that line values we have put the limit. And then with the horizontal directions, we can resolve the horizontal, already in the horizontal, we resolve this in the horizontal direction, we find out the relative velocity in the horizontal direction, and we integrated this one, and again cos theta terms came here, and that cos v cos the dt integration calculated from this, we eliminate, after substituting, we eliminated this, and we obtained this value. Now you take a homework for this. Suppose that this missile is moving with a velocity u. And the rocket is moving with a velocity v, and u is not equal to v. And if it is given that u, because both are same, they were never meeting, and u is greater than v. So the speed of the missile is more than speed of the rocket. Then in that case, you'll be going and hitting this one. So the same problem you solve, if it is as high as there, it is going with a v velocity. This is moving with a u velocity, but constant speed, but variable direction. Then after what time it will be striking this one? After what time they will be, the missile will be hitting this one. U, V, two different quantity you take, and U is greater than this. This is for the missile, and this is for the rocket. Then find out after what time it will be hitting the rocket. After what time it will be hitting the rocket. So solve this problem. We'll be coming with the solution of that in the next video. Till that time, we'll keep trying, and hope you have enjoyed the solution of this problem.